the undefeated, the villain, Dillion Way.
Does Dillion White, 15-0 as a professional, 12 stoppages, never passed four rounds, however. And we know what the subplot here is. The only man in the amateurs to beat Anthony Joshua. He and Joshua are on collision course in this arena in December. First, White has got to do the job against Brian Minto, and talking to Dillion White in the build-up to this one, he says he needs some rounds. He wants to pick up a few more rounds. But that's going to be very hard for Brian Minto to give away something like 2.5 stone to this fella, who, if nothing else, has a terrific body shot.
Yeah, but Minto has experienced, and I think he's used to the other guys that have the weight advantage. He's small for a heavyweight. I think this is a good choice of opponent. You know, Minto's not a spoiler usually, so he'll give it a good go and hopefully get a few rounds in the bank. And that's exactly what Dillion White will need before he faces Anthony Joshua.
Been taking things very, very seriously since they started putting his name in the frame with Anthony Joshua. He's hired Jonathan Banks as his trainer. That's Vladimir Klitschko's trainer. And for this one, he's been working out of the Croc Gym in Detroit, taking the business extremely seriously now at 27 years old, Dillion White.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, Eddie Hearn's Matchroom Sport proudly present 10 rounds of boxing for the vacant WBC International Silver Heavyweight Championship. Sponsored by Dapperbet, StubHub and Scott's Menswear. And a very special welcome to the viewers joining us live on Sky Sports. We continue to bring you the very best ringside seat in the business. All the officials have been appointed by the British Boxing Water Control and the World Boxing Council, whose supervisor is joining us at ringside from Rome, Italy, and that's Mauro Betti. Our steward in charge from the Boxing Water Control is Mr. Mick Collier. Our area representatives are Desiree and Bill Edwards. Inspector Richard Barber is our chief inspector and has appointed in the red and blue corner Nigel Thomas and himself, Richard Barber. The three scoring judges from Gillingham, Ian John Lewis, from Wellingborough, Mr. John Keane, and from Watford, Mr. Bob Williams. And when the action begins and the bell rings, the man in charge from Paisley, Scotland, Mr. Victor Loughlin. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here we go, introducing to you, fighting out of the red corner, wearing the black trunks, trimmed with silver, weighed in at 15 stone, 2 pounds, with a 50 fight record, 41 wins, 26. Inside the scheduled distance and just 9 defeats. Ladies and gentlemen, he comes to the ring as a former world title challenger from Butler, Pennsylvania, USA. Time to unleash the beast, Brian Minto! And across the ring, undefeated. Fighting out of the blue corner where the black trunks trimmed with gold and red. Weighed in, 17 stone, 11 pounds, 1 ounce, 15 fight record, 15 wins, 12 inside the scheduled distance. From Brixton, South London, ladies and gentlemen, here he is, the villain, Dillion White. time with the bell, Bobby, to offer a referee in charge, Victor Loxton. And now it's 10 rounds of boxing for the vacant WBC International Silver Heavyweight Champion.
Hey guys, you've had your instructions in the restroom room. Remember, obey my commands at all time. Defend yourselves at all time. God bless. Touch gloves.
Interesting to see that reaction that Dillon Whyte got from the crowd. He's been certainly talking up a storm in terms of his rivalry with Anthony Joshua. Sounds like he's turned a few people against him. But the main thing is, he's getting noticed. He's drawn some attention to himself. And he's on the threshold of a big, big fight here, assuming he can get past the experienced and the normally very durable Brian Minto, who's boxed in this country before a couple of years ago in a prize fight. We saw him beat Tom Little before losing to Michael Sprott. And there's some very good names on Minto's resume down the years. Unfortunately, he's lost to most of them. He's what the Americans would call a tweener, not quite big enough to be a useful heavyweight, a little bit too big to really make it comfortably at cruiserweight. His highlight came a few years ago when he boxed Marco Huck for the world cruiserweight title. It was 9 very one-sided rounds. He showed terrific heart that night, but didn't win a round. And there's some other good names in there as well, the likes of Chris Areola and most recently Joseph Parker 14 months ago. Parker, another rising prospect, he took him out. And the question is, how good can Dillon Whyte look against Brian Minto, and how quickly can he land one of those body shots have done for so many of his previous opponents?
You know, the main thing for White is that he takes his time, doesn't become frustrated, because Minto's tricky. He knows his way around the ring. He can make fighters look bad if they go looking for the KO too early. So it's just a case of concentration, keep your mind on the job and take your time. So there already he's been caught with his defences nowhere.
Massive weight difference between the two, 2.5 stone. And, White getting through with his right hand lead there. Minto was telling me yesterday, he said he was offered this fight a few weeks ago, turned it down because the money wasn't right for him. So they brought in Dominic Gwynn, but when Gwynn got injured, he got the call again, and I'm sure he negotiated a very good deal for himself this time.
Well, that's two solid right hands that White's got through with. Minto's taken them well. But they were solid shots, so he's finding the range with the right hand pretty early. Minto can't afford to take too many of those.
Just missing with a big swinging right hand there. Minto, and he will, as you say, Jim, he'll come and give it a go. And generally speaking, he looks after himself. Really trying to take it to Dillon Whyte, and I think the crowd appreciate this.
Yeah, just shipped another solid right hand there.
And there's another one. There's a body shot coming in. Minto absorbed that pretty well. And he's doing his best to try and bully Dillon Whyte in there. But that weight differential is going to be very hard for Minto to overcome. Nice work again from Minto, but those punches just bouncing off White.
White's a little bit vulnerable when he's throwing his own punches. I'm thinking beyond this fight to the Joshua thing. I mean, you've got to get your chin down and think about punches.
That big right hand, right on the belt. Another look into his corner there. Looks like he's going to be okay. Victor Loughlin waiting for him to get up, and Jumbo Johnson, who is running his corner. Well, it's damage limitation for Jumbo
spot,
and Brian Minto.
He's standing in that spot too long.
Well, we're saying he couldn't afford to take too many more of those, and that's exactly what happened. He took another one, and that was a beauty. He's bang on the chin. Did well to get back up again. The bell sounded just as he hit the floor. You can see the impact of that. He cannot afford to take any more of those, but to his credit, he's giving it a go. He's here to earn his money. He's not trying to survive. He doesn't spoil. He gives it a real go. But I think White was finding the range far too early with the right hand.
Yeah, he took too many of those right hands. I just think 14 months ago, He went seven rounds with Joseph Parker. Brian Minto is another one of those rising prospects. If White can get him out of here really early, well, you'd expect him to beat Brian Minto, of course, but to get rid of him early would give him an awful lot of satisfaction and just show that his power is for real. Minto again looking to land his counters, but you can see they're just bouncing off Dylan White. He gets a body shot in there, nice left hook. Minto showing tremendous guts here.
See, White doesn't want this to become messy. You know, he should give himself room to work. As Minto gets close, he's going to be a pest, and he's taking punches, really, he shouldn't be taking.
Well, White showing up some defensive vulnerability here in this fight. And if he does meet Anthony Joshua in a couple of months, you can be certain the Joshua camp will be analysing the tape on this one.
Yeah, he should get the jab moving, you know, start building his attacks. You know, he's a little bit bomb happy at the moment, White. He's a big success in the opening round with the right hand. But yeah, just break this fellow down with the jab, set up the right hand. Ah, that was a good shot.
Yeah, and it just shook him to his boots, and he's trying to buy himself some time here, Brian Minto. Body shot straight to the midsection there. Minto grimaces, grits his teeth. Swings away again. Just can't make any kind of an impression on a man that's 2.5 stone heavier than he is. A short jolting right hand from White. Minto is visibly slowing down in front of our eyes here as we get inside the last minute of this second round. Again, another brave assault from the man from Pittsburgh.
Yeah, White should be turning on there, put him in the corner. I mean, he has the weight advantage. You can bully this fellow around. He's taking some real big powerful shots, Minto. Full credit to him.
There, White, he looks to load up and really could have caught a nasty counter there as he just loaded up and left himself wide open.
You see, White should be using this in preparation for the Joshua fight. He should be using his jab, think what he's doing. Should be setting up the right hand with the jab. Just a little bit bomb happy at the moment, and this fellow's tough. He'll take a clean shot to get him out of there.
Looked pretty crude in that last round, loading up, swinging away, leaving himself wide open. Again, he's shaken Minto, and Minto wisely shows his experience, takes a knee, a little shake of the head towards the corner there. As he's taking the full count up to 9, and then he's, in fact, no, he's not even going to make it. He shook his head as at the corner there, early in that count. Now that's pretty harsh for this crowd, I have to say. They didn't take that punch.
But the crowd are not happy. If a fighter, I mean, the crowd feel they paid their money, they feel if a fighter can get up, they should get up. But, I mean, he took some tremendous punches before the end there, and that final one really was a sickener. So...
Well, I must admit, Jim, I saw him take the knee and you just thought, good, he's using his experience, he'll take an 8 count here and a 9 count, but it was that little shake of the head to the corner immediately at about 3. He knew he was in a bit of trouble and he's on his stool now. and the paramedics are on standby. Let's see if we can see exactly what happened here.
Now, because there's not usually,
That was on the ear, wasn't it?
Yeah, you look at the legs there. You look at the legs there, the impact of that punch and the effect it had on his legs, and straight away he's looking over, he's hurt, feels he's got nothing else to offer.
And they're giving him oxygen right now.
Yeah, you see, you know, there's a real solid left hook there, and you saw the effect of the punch on his legs. And as I say, this is a guy who doesn't really have any quit in him. So he really must have been hurt by that. And you look at his contribution up to now, he was giving everything he had, jolting it right hand, down he goes, little delayed effect. And straight away, you look into the corner. Feel a little bit sorry for White, because he probably won't get an awful lot of credit, because Minto did quit, took a knee and decided to stay there, so it takes the kind of shine off of White's performance. It's a pity, because in the time the fight lasted, White was taking some punches that he shouldn't have been taking, so good. He would probably have preferred a cleaner finish.
Good to see that he's managed to get off the stool and make his way back to his corner, but again, he's just holding a glove up to his ear. Jumbo Johnson's, I'm looking at that now, I think that's where it caught him, and it's done his balance. So there we go. He wanted rounds. Well, he got two and a bit.
Ladies and gentlemen, timekeeper Bob Edgeworth has recorded a time of 26 seconds of the third round. Victor Loughlin has stopped the contest. Minto in no position to continue. Therefore, your winner and a new WBC International Silver Heavyweight Champion from Brixton, South London, the body snatcher, Dillian White.
Well, Dillian, congratulations. Big entrance, then big punching. Although the ending was a little bit of an anti-climax, what was your take on it?
Yeah, it was all right. I injured my shoulder in training. I wasn't throwing my left hook or my jab a lot. I went a bit right-hand crazy, you know, but stuff happened. Listen, I don't pull out of fights because of the injury, and you know, I show up and I fight, whatever happened. But it's cool. I got the job done. It wasn't the cleanest of job, but got it done.
Jonathan Banks in the corner thought you were a little bit sloppy at times, but it was exciting for the crowd, although you did get hit occasionally.
he said to me, he said, listen, that round was terrible. He said, you know, dude, you're much better than this, what are you doing? But he knew I was carrying a heavy shoulder injury, so, you know, listen, man.
So how bad is your shoulder injury now, and will it possibly scupper the fight in December, assuming Anthony Joshua wins tonight?
I'll show up December, don't worry about that. December I'll show up. If I have one arm and one leg, I'll show up December.
Tell us what you've been working on in the gym at the Kronk in Detroit.
We've been working in just basics, really. Jabs, 1-2, you know, left hook, right hands, jabs, double jab and triple jab. I was a bit disappointed I couldn't execute as much as I studied off jabbing, but you know, then my shoulder was I flicked the jab and I felt my shoulder, but I thought, you know what, whatever, I'm gonna do something else. And that's what fighting is about. It's about adapting, and you know, something hurts or something don't work, and go to something else, and that's what I've done. I'm not really a guy that throw a lot of right hands. I throw mainly my jab and my left hook and stuff and whatever, but you know, I had to change it to something else, so you know.
That's your seventh straight knockout since the inactivity after the ban. Do you feel ready for Anthony Joshua now? Tell us why you're convinced you're going to beat him.
Listen, I know the Joshua fight's going to be a good fight, a hard fight, but I'm ready. Like I said, I don't want to be one of those guys that keep fighting guys with losing record that already mentally, you know, you're going to win them fights 70% anyway. So, you know, I want to, as I'm in the game, to put on good fights, test myself and give the fans good fights, because the fans support me when I had my 2-year suspension. So, you know, that's what I'm here to do, and to win the British title and move on, you know.
From Gillingham, Ian John Lewis. From Wellingborough, Mr. John King. And from Watford, Mr. Bob Williams. And when the action begins and the bell rings, the man in charge, from Paisley, Scotland, Mr. Victor Loughlin. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here we go, introducing to you fighting out of the red corner, wearing the black trunks, suit with silver, weighing at 15 stone, 2 pounds, with a 50-fight record, 41 wins, 26 inside the scheduled distance, and just 9 defeats. Ladies and gentlemen, he comes to the ring as a former world title challenger from Butler, Pennsylvania, USA. Time to unleash the beast, Brian Minto! And across the ring, undefeated. Fighting out of the blue corner where the black trunks trim with gold and red. Weighed in, 17 stone, 11 pounds, 1 ounce. 15 fight record, 15 wins, 12 inside the scheduled distance. From Brixton, South London, ladies and gentlemen, here he is, the villain, Dillian White! Time for the bell, Bob Edgeworth, a referee in charge, Victor Loxton, and now it's 10 rounds of boxing for the vacant WBC International Silver Heavyweight Champion.
Hey guys, you've had your instructions in the restroom. Remember, obey my commands at all time. Defend yourselves at all time. God bless. Touch gloves.
Interesting to see that reaction that Dillian White got from the crowd. He's been certainly talking up a storm in terms of his rivalry with Anthony Joshua. Sounds like he's turned a few people against him. But the main thing is, he's getting noticed. He's drawn some attention to himself. And he's on the threshold of a big, big fight here, assuming he can get past the experienced and the normally very durable Brian Minto, who's boxed in this country before a couple of years ago in a prize fight. We saw him beat Tom Little before losing to Michael Sprott. And there's some very good names on Minto's resume down the years. Unfortunately, he's lost to most of them. He's what the Americans would call a tweener, not quite big enough to be a useful heavyweight, a little bit too big to really make it comfortably at cruiserweight. His highlight came a few years ago when he boxed Marco Huck for the world cruiserweight title. It was 9 very one-sided rounds. He showed terrific heart that night, but didn't win a round. And there's some other good names in there as well, the likes of Chris Areola and most recently Joseph Parker 14 months ago. Parker, another rising prospect, he took him out. And the question is, how good can Dillian White look against Brian Minto, and how quickly can he land one of those body shots have done for so many of his previous opponents?
You know, the main thing for White is that he takes his time, doesn't become frustrated, because Minto's tricky. He knows his way around the ring. He can make fighters look bad if they go looking for the KO too early. So it's just a case of concentration, keep your mind on the job and take your time. See, there already he's been caught with his defences nowhere.
Massive weight difference between the two. 2.5 stone. And, White getting through with his right hand lead there. Minto was telling me yesterday, he said he was offered this fight a few weeks ago. He turned it down because the money wasn't right for him. So they brought in Dominic Gwynn, but when Gwynn got injured, he got the call again, and I'm sure he negotiated a very good deal for himself this time.
Last two solid right hands that White's got through with. Minto's taken them well, but they were solid shots, so he's finding the range with the right hand pretty early. Minto can't afford to take too many of those.
He's missing with a big swinging right hand there, Minto, and he will, as you say, Jim, he'll come and give it a go, and generally speaking, he looks after himself. Really trying to take it to Dillian White, and I think the crowd appreciate
another,
this.
Yeah, just shipped another solid right hand there.
And there's another one. There's a body shot coming in. Minto absorbed that pretty well. And he's doing his best to try and bully Dillian White in there. But that weight differential is going to be very hard for Minto to overcome. Nice work again from Minto, but those punches just bouncing off White.
White's a little bit vulnerable when he's throwing his own punches. I'm thinking beyond this fight to the Joshua thing. I mean, you've got to get your chin down and think about punches.
Oh, that big right hand. right on the bell. Well, a look into his corner there. Looks like he's going to be okay. Victor Loughlin waiting for him to get up, and Jumbo Johnson, who is running his corner. Well, it's damage limitation for Jumbo and Brian Minto.
He's standing in that spot too long.
Well, we're saying he couldn't afford to take too many more of those, and that's exactly what happened. He took another one, and that was a beauty. He's bang on the chin. Did well to get back up again. The bell sounded just as he hit the floor. You can see the impact of that. He cannot afford to take any more of those. But to his credit, he's giving it a go. He's here to earn his money. He's not trying to survive. He doesn't spoil. He gives it a real go. But I think White was finding the range far too early with the right hand.
Yeah, he took too many of those right hands. I just think 14 months ago, he went seven rounds with Joseph Parker. Brian Minto is another one of those rising prospects. If White can get him out of here really early, well, you'd expect him to beat Brian Minto, of course, but to get rid of him early would give him an awful lot of satisfaction and just show that his power is for real. Minto again looking to land his counters, but you can see they're just bouncing off Dylan White and gets a body shot in there.
The undefeated, the villain, Dillian Wade.
Entrance does Dylan White, 15-0 as a professional, 12 stoppages, never passed four rounds, however. And we know what the subplot here is. The only man in the amateurs to beat Anthony Joshua. He and Joshua are on collision course in this arena in December. First, White has got to do the job against Brian Minto, and talking to Dylan White in the build-up to this one, he says he needs some rounds. He wants to pick up a few more rounds. But that's going to be very hard for Brian Minto to give away something like 2.5 stone to this fella, who, if nothing else, has a terrific body shot.
Yeah, but Minto is experienced, and I think he's used to the other guys that have the weight advantage. He is small for a heavyweight. I think this is a good choice of opponent. You know, Minto is not a spoiler usually, so he'll give it a good go and hopefully get a few rounds in the bank. And that's exactly what Dillian White will need before he faces Anthony Joshua.
Been taking things very, very seriously since they started putting his name in the frame with Anthony Joshua. He's hired Jonathan Banks as his trainer. That's Vladimir Klitschko's trainer. And for this one, he's been working out of the Croc Gym in Detroit, taking the business extremely seriously now at 27 years old, Dillian White.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, Eddie Hearn's Matchroom Sport proudly present 10 rounds of boxing for the vacant WBC International Silver Heavyweight Championship, sponsored by Dufferbet, StubHub and Scott's Menswear. And a very special welcome to the viewers joining us live on Sky Sports. We continue to bring you the very best ringside seat in the business. All the officials have been appointed by the British Boxing Board of Control and the World Boxing Council, whose supervisor is joining us at ringside from Rome, Italy, and that's Mauro Betti. Our steward in charge from the Boxing Board of Control is Mr. Mick Collier. Our area representatives are Des Reese and Bill Edwards. Inspector Richard Barber is our chief inspector and has appointed in the red and blue corner Nigel Thomas and himself, Richard Barber. The three scoring judges
A nice left hook. Minto showing tremendous guts here.
Right, step back. There we go.
See, White doesn't want this to become messy. You know, he should give himself room to work. If Minto gets close, he's going to be a pest, and he's taking punches, really, he shouldn't be taking.
Well, White showing up some defensive vulnerability here in this fight. If he does meet Anthony Joshua in a couple of months, you can be certain the Joshua camp will be analysing the tape on this one.
Yeah, he should get the jab moving, you know, start building his attacks. You know, he's a little bit bomb happy at the moment, White. He's a big success in the opening round with the right hand. But yeah, just break this fellow down with the jab, set up the right hand. Ah, that was a good shot.
Yeah, and it just shook into his boots, and he's trying to buy himself some time here, Brian Minto. Body shot straight to the midsection there. Minto grimaces, grits his teeth, swings away again. Just can't make any kind of an impression on a man that's 2.5 stone heavier than he is. A short jolting right hand from White. Minto is visibly slowing down in front of our eyes here as we get inside the last minute of this second round. Again, another brave assault from the man from Pittsburgh.
Yeah, White should be turning on there, put him in the corner. I mean, he has the weight advantage. You can bully this fellow around. He's taking some real big, powerful shots, Minto. Full credit to him.
He looks to load up and really could have caught a nasty counter there as he just loaded up and left himself wide open.
You see, White should be using this in preparation for the Joshua fight. He should be using his jab, think what he's doing. He should be setting up the right hand with the jab. Just a little bit bomb happy at the moment, and this fellow's tough. He'll take a clean shot to get him out of there.
Looked pretty crude in that last round. Loading up, swinging away, leaving himself wide open. Again, he's shaken Minto. And Minto wisely shows his experience. Takes a knee, a little shake of the head towards the corner there. As he's taking the full count up to 9, and then he's, in fact, no, he's not even going to make it. He shook his head at the corner there, early in that count. Well, that's pretty harsh from this crowd, I have to say. They didn't take that punch.
But the crowd are not happy. If a fighter, I mean, the crowd feel, they paid their money, they feel if a fighter can get up, they should get up. But, I mean, he took some tremendous punches before the end there, and that final one really was a sickener. So,
well, I must admit, Jim, I saw him take the knee and you just thought, good, he's using his experience, he'll take an 8 count here and a 9 count, but it was that little shake of the head to the corner immediately at about 3. He knew he was in a bit of trouble and he's on his stool now. And the paramedics are on standby. Let's see if we can see exactly what happened here.
Now, because there's not usually...
That was on the ear, wasn't it?
Yeah, you know, you look at the legs there. You look at the legs there, the impact of that punch and the effect it had on his legs, and straight away he's looking over, he's hurt, feels he's got nothing else to offer.
And they're giving him oxygen right now.
Yeah, you see, you know, there's a real solid left hook there, and you saw the effect of the punch on his legs. And as I say, this is a guy who doesn't really have any quit in him. So he really must have been hurt by that. And you look at the, his contribution up to now, he was giving everything he had, jolting it, right hand, down he goes, little delayed effect, and straight away looking to the corner. Feel a little bit sorry for White, because he probably won't get an awful lot of credit, because Minto did quit, took a knee and decided to stay there, so it takes the kind of shine off of White's performance. It's a pity, because in the time the fight lasted, White was taking some punches that he shouldn't have been taking. So good. He would probably have preferred a cleaner finish.
Good to see that he's managed to get off the stool and make his way back to his corner, but again, he's just holding a glove up to his ear. Jumbo Johnson's, I'm looking at that now, I think that's where it caught him, and it's done his balance. So there we go, he wanted rounds, well, he got two and a bit.
Ladies and gentlemen, timekeeper Bob Edgeworth has recorded a time of 26 seconds of the third round. Victor Lachlan has stopped the contest. Minto in no position to continue, therefore your winner and a new WBC International Silver Heavyweight Champion from Brixton, South London, the body snatcher, Dillian White.
Well, Dillian, congratulations. Big entrance, then big punching. Although the ending was a little bit of an anti-climax, what was your take on it?
It was all right.